Hold on, I don't know the words. It's been a long day. Did they say it again? And my name is Charlie Puthin.
Puth.
I give you attention.
It's Puth. No, they want attention. Oh, he said he's not giving them attention.
Oh, wait. Yeah, okay. You just get attention.
You just want attention.
Oh, want? Okay. Yeah. I just want attention.
No, that's not how the song goes.
That's why I'm partying. Me and John required validation from you.
That's good.
Give our podcast a like and subscribe on the tube.
Okay.
Hold on.
Keep going.
And follow us on Spotify too. Ooh.
I like that.
Ooh.
That's good.
We've been running round all around. And our legs hurt. No. Wait, hold on. I have. John.
You're about to start it the way I know you're going to start it. I'm not going to like it.
John,
you're going to start this.
I'm a little under the weather.
We're both under the weather.
I think we need a doctor.
Emergency. Paging Dr. B.
I knew this was going to happen. What the fuck? Here, put your ass back in the goddamn seat. How dare you get up and start shaking your ass?
I'm watching myself.
You were under the weather.
I just got above the weather. Because the doctor saved me.
Inside of me.
Dance with me, John. Dance with me. We're going to do that look back thing that we tried to do a bit ago, but we didn't do it the first time. Ready? Hey. Ready?
Hey, doctor, could you give me something?
You didn't do it with me.
I'm not doing it with you.
Man.
Have you ever had a dream?
Hey.
That you...
I pressed the wrong button. Hey, welcome back to the soup. Whoa, almost said the
wrong show. That's a wrong
show.
Podcast. We've been doing this for over a month now.
I haven't, dude. We haven't done that podcast that I was about to say in like 6 years.
That's one of the botched podcasts that we. New year, new me.
Oh shit! I almost said the super fun
welcome
time show.
Welcome to the Playing Pod
with Alex and John.
I'm John.
I'm Alex.
We're both sick.
No,
we're both
I just got healed. Just right now.
By the doctor?
By the good doctor.
Who has the beat. Playing Pod with Alex and John.
But, John.
Go ahead.
Not only are we the only video game podcast that plays while you pod, verified by one quick Google search with no clicks on the results.
That's right.
We're also the only podcast that brings smoke.
That's right.
John.
Yeah.
If you or anybody you know
right.
cast any kind of pod and wants any kind of ass whooping...
Call me now for your free whipping.
Come get some smoke. Any game.
While supplies last.
While supplies last, yeah. Any game whatsoever except for...
What's the game today?
Donkey Kong Country.
That's true. You can't really you can't get the work in Donkey Kong Country. You can't.
You really can't.
It's a
single-player
game.
Unless we do some speedrun shit, but I'm not about
that.
Nah,
that's not the same.
Not about it. Any game, you say it. Me and John, beat your ass. 2v2, 1v1, 3v4.
That's right. Bitch.
So, shouts out to the Spotify people.
Yes.
The listeners, all 9 of you, estimated.
That's right.
I said I wanted 10, but y'all let me down to hurt my feelings, but
that's
cool.
That's okay.
I forgive you. And also, the YouTube audience, that's the only way you can actually see the full, quote-unquote, experience where you can see the game that we're playing. And
that's
today,
right.
That is Mortal Kombat 11.
That's right.
Yes.
Hey! That's right, Mortal Kombat 11. The new fighter, Joker, came out, and that gives me an excuse to play the game. Because I want to play.
So we listen to our audience members. We're really good at that.
Yeah, here. A lot of you.
I got complaints saying that we.
A lot of one of you said.
We talk too much about Mortal Kombat. There's other stuff to talk about. So we're going to play it today.
So
you
call me now
your
free whipping.
We don't have that one anymore.
Yeah, we used to come get it.
Oh, yeah. You can shut up. Matter of fact.
Perfect. Yeah,
there you
perfect
go.
Ass whooping.
There you go.
That's right.
Hey, fun fact. This one. And this one. From Mortal Kombat. You're welcome. So even when we don't talk about it, but I want him to know now. This is a Mortal Kombat podcast.
Free whipping.
This is a Mortal Kombat podcast now.
Technically, you could.
So.
I think they have a combat class.
They do.
Yeah, where they show off the new fighters and they do the challenges.
Yeah, they
and
do.
Stuff like that.
It's pretty boring.
Excuse me?
I don't have the attention span to sit there and watch a podcast just on here's
One
a new
game.
Fighter. No, on just here's a new fighter.
I don't want to talk shit, but I saw... like when I was looking through other gaming podcasts, I saw that somebody had
a pod and play.
Yeah,
with Jacob and Al's Toy Barn.
It was like Alan and Jay.
Alan and Jay. Oh, that's better than what I said.
It was like podcast and play with Alan and Jay. No, I saw this. Instead of play and play, but no, I saw somebody had another gaming podcast.
There's a hair in my coffee.
There's a hair in your coffee. Mm-hmm. Well, don't do that. Damn it. He had a podcast that had updates on Destiny 2. So each one was like a different thing on like Destiny.
I'm talking shit.
I don't even know.
Oh, I'm talking shit. Here it comes.
And I don't want to talk shit. Alex will do that for me.
I'm gonna do it. Oh my god.
But I don't know why I was just like, what? Like, I don't play Destiny, and I don't plan on playing it. But I was just like, how much is in that game for you to do that? You know, like how much is in that game for you to just make a whole podcast series on it? You know.
You know what, man?
What?
I'm not gonna talk shit.
You just said you were.
I'm not. I can't. I'm turning over a new leaf. Leafs have been turned.
They flipped.
And flipped. Can't do it.
If you're going what I think you're doing, I don't fucking like it.
Give me a hint.
Okay, so you don't know what you're doing.
No, give me a hint, because I would love to take it where you didn't want me to.
No, why would I help you?
Because I love nothing more than to.
Okay, I guess. I thought you were going to talk about Animal Crossing.
What's that got to do with flipping? Oh!
New leaf.
Oh! Oh!
Oh, I gave you way too much credit.
Yeah, no, here we go. You ready? I'm going to do that again. Credit. Oh, man, I'm not going to talk shit because a leaf was turned. Animal Crossing Switch.
And you fucked it. You fucked it. I gave it to you, and you fucked it. How do you do that?
John, we have a system here, John. We're at the pre-podcast banter part. And then we go into the topics.
This is the monologue.
This is the SNL monologue at the beginning. You're fucking it.
Me?
Yeah, you. You tried to segue it too long. You know, the brain has to warm up.
I thought you were trying to segue.
No, I wasn't. I wasn't quite ready yet. Also, I forgot that Animal Crossing New Leaf or whatever. I've never seen this, but came out. So.
Well, the fatality is happening right now with Joker. And for Spotify listeners, Pop Goes the Weasel is the hint.
That's pretty cool. All right. You threw off my momentum, and now I'm upset.
I'm sorry.
Restart from the beginning.
Go ahead.
Of the podcast.
All right. Welcome to the pod. Playing John, Alex, Alan, and Jay.
No. I said we weren't going to necessarily talk about it, and we're not going to talk about it, but I feel like we have to mention it.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, that's it. We're not going to go into a long, deep discussion. But
plus, it's already been a week. Not only that. But I mean, like.
It's been a week. It no longer matters.
We're over it.
Not like that. No,
it
just, Yeah, obviously, when we recorded the podcast last week, we recorded it on Thursday. The unfortunate news of Kobe Bryant's passing happened on Sunday. So, not that we would go into a deep dive anyway, because we're not that. But just.
But if there was if you noticed a lack of it,
of
just mentioning it.
It's because we filmed it way in advance.
Yeah.
And it wasn't ready. So, I mean, that's unfortunate. Our condolences go out to.
Yeah, I would just feel bad not talking about it. And all the families involved that.
Yeah, that's it. Just have to bring that up.
It would just feel weird not to mention it at all.
See, I was about to start talking about it, but now I'm not going to do that.
But what the fuck do you want, Alex?
No, because I was about to say just the, now we're talking about it. Okay.
You did it.
Because I was watching the Lakers game yesterday. No, 2 days ago. 3 days ago when this comes out. Uh-huh. It was the Lakers versus the Trailblazers. And they did the Kobe Bryant tribute, and everybody had the Kobe jerseys in the crowd. Uh-huh. And, like, the city was just out. Like, that shit is crazy. I've never seen such a coming together.
There's so much love for Kobe.
Yeah. It's like.
Again, we didn't want to do a deep.
I know. I'm just making a note. Like, I've never seen something. Like, when Michael Jackson died, it was a big thing. When Prince died, it was a big thing. But, like, I've never seen a worldwide just, you know.
Dude, my Instagram, like, people from all walks of life had their pictures with Kobe and how much they meant to him. Like, Jonah Hill had pictures with Kobe. Fucking, it was like Drake, a bunch of other people. Yeah. Just everybody just had something that they were impacted with Kobe. And I was just like, this is like, I don't watch basketball like that, but I'm like, this hurt a lot of people. Like, damn.
My Instagram feed,
it was
for the first 2 days it was like Kobe, Kobe, Taco Bell ad, Kobe, ass, Kobe, Taco Bell.
Mine was like ass, Kobe, some titties. than a Taco Bell ad.
Instagram, filthy boy.
My Instagram is pretty filthy.
Instagram is filthy. But yeah, that just have to mention it. Wouldn't feel right to have a entertainment, gonna, video game, pop culture podcast
and not mention one of the
biggest things that happened.
Black Mamba.
Yeah.
Wait, real quick. My favorite thing ever that Kobe's ever done is that fucking that Nike like commercial
with Kanye
where he's like, but are you a different animal and the same beast?
Yeah,
like I fucking loved that. Like that
commercial's
shit
hilarious.
And like when you really think about it, it's true though. Like it's like you keep the same momentum, but somewhere else it's like.
Yeah, no, I got what you're saying. Kanye didn't get it.
Nah, Kanye's stupid.
Hey, no, he's from Chicago.
You're a jackass and you're from Chicago too.
True, but now he's having a rough patch right now. Just give him a sec; he'll be back.
Damn, this man found Christ.
Yeah, that's a rough patch.
He's in a rough patch. Oh my God.
Hey man, musically he's in a rough patch. He needs to lose God.
Jesus.
Yeah, him too. No, I'm obviously joking.
So
I'm just not the biggest fan of the last couple of like projects he put out.
You know,
ever since
podcast,
he found
we
Jesus,
we never really talk about games.
Well, yeah, we do. We talk about Mortal Kombat.
Oh,
what else are we talking about here?
No, you're right.
No, okay. Let's talk about games. Right. Let's talk about the games they play. So Fast and Furious dropped a new trailer, and these boys are playing some games.
I was wondering what you were going with. That's a. Why couldn't you just do the New Leaf one, man? Why couldn't you just do that one?
John.
I gave you too much credit.
I have to keep the audience on their toes, all right? Most podcasts have some sort of coherency and a structure, you know?
You got to really pay attention when you listen to us. Because you're not even going to know what we're talking about.
Let's say you're listening and you zone out for 3 seconds. We're on six different topics later.
Yeah, we're on like six different tangents that had nothing to do with the first one.
And right now, we're on Fast 9. Furious 9. The Fast Saga 9.
No, they don't do the Furious no more.
They're Fast 9, the Furious Saga, whatever. Dropped a new trailer, and you know what?
I'm upset.
I love this franchise.
I fucking hate this franchise.
I love it. You know why? Because this franchise follows the Saints Row I was telling you earlier. They're the Saints Row of movies. The first Saints Row was a serious, quote-unquote, game where, you know, it wasn't super crazy. It was a Grand Theft Auto clone. Based on the gangs and all that good stuff. And it was very grounded for the most part, right? Yeah, very grounded in reality. Like the first maybe two movies. I'll give it three. And then Saints Row 2 comes out. And they amped it up just a little bit. I mean, okay, no, they amped it up a lot. Then Saints Row the Third came out. And all of a sudden you're swinging dildo bats and you're doing some crazy shit and you're flying.
Clusterfuck.
Eventually you keep following that franchise, you become the president and you're a goddamn superhero in virtual reality. Like, you know, like that franchise went.
And then it's like, oh, you're in a simulation, aliens took over or some shit.
Yeah. See, now.
Like, how do you go from just a random street gang to president fighting aliens?
Yeah. So, again.
There's no coherency there.
Now Fast and Furious, you know, it was a very serious racing car, you know, there was a gang.
Street, underground.
Yeah. And now, fast forward, John Cena stopped a car with his bare hand.
Oh, no. John Cena is fucking,
Diesel's brother.
Vin Diesel's brother, which, no.
Nine movies later.
Like, where have you been? Not, what do you mean you're his brother?
Yeah, you're totally different ethnicity. Whatever, look, anyway.
John Cena's white.
Yeah, I know. Look, anyway. I don't know what Vin Diesel is.
Vin Diesel's mix, no?
I don't know. He's the god.
He's question mark.
So you got to love the franchise because, again, very grounded. It moves on, you know, motherfuckers punching buildings with hands and knocking down parking structures.
I'm sorry.
Tackling people in the air and landing on tanks and not dying. What happened?
I'm not fighting.
You've been not playing this whole time?
No, I was playing the last one.
Oh, but anyway, the franchise just goes crazy now. There's a
The Rock.
They drove cars through the buildings in Dubai at one of them.
See, that was just enough where it was okay. You know, like that was just enough. Okay, yeah. Like
no,
if your car's fast enough, sure, maybe you can land on the other side.
What the hell?
No, but then when you got motherfuckers pushing whole torpedoes and bringing down helicopters or ground.
Oh, like Hobbs and Shaw and shit?
Yeah. Like you mentioned Vin Diesel fucking curb stomping the ground saying the streets always win.
But if the building structure is damaged enough, he could technically apply the right amount of force
Wait.
To knock it down. Just saying.
No.
Just saying.
I know he didn't. I'll tell you that much.
He obviously did because that building fell.
I'll tell you he didn't.
He obviously fell. And motherfuckers just coming back to life left and right. That's cool.
Yeah.
So I love the franchise. I don't care. I'm excited just because at this point, it's not necessarily about the story because at this one, they could say that they're all related. You know, it turns out that what's-her-face, Michelle Rodriguez, was her sister the whole time, and now they have an incest crazy baby who was like a super mutant dinosaur. They could do that, and I'd be cool. It's all about what stupid shit are they going to do with cars from here on out.
See, my thing,
I want to see where else could they possibly take this?
You know what this is? This is why can't I take AI fighter off? I don't understand.
Because maybe that's that tower. It says AI fighter required.
Well, let's have a conversation. I'll let Joker take care of it. We'll have a conversation. All right.
You want to throw off the momentum of the audio podcast one more time?
No, I'm sorry. I was confused. All right.
The screen.
I can't read.
Anyway, Fast and Furious crazy. Dropped the cool trailer. No. Han's back for some reason. No.
My thing with Fast and Furious is up to this point, it's essentially like the writers are like they just watch their kids do shit and they're like, yeah, let's put that in the movie. Like, a fucking car drives off like running away from the cops, jumps off a ledge. Oh, we have a jet that has magnets to pick up the car midair so that it can take it. Oh, this car is, there's no bridge. It's okay. The rope that's probably been there forever, it's probably loose as shit, ties to the wheel and the car swings and shit.
Hey, man.
Fucking. How many buildings did John Cena put
Vin Diesel through? He put him like four.
John Cena pushed a whole car. Like, it's a child. It's a child playing with his toys. Like,
yeah. What if like three movies from now, it zooms out and it's like the Lego movie.
That's exactly what I'm thinking. It's like.
Or, you know, was a dream and they were in a simulation, though. Like, they're in the Matrix.
I'd be so mad.
If they were in the Matrix? Like,
you know how at the end of Men in Black, they're talking about the universe, and then right at the end it pulls out, and then our galaxy is literally just a marble for other aliens to just like play marbles. Like,
yeah,
that's what this is. It's just like if you pull back, it's just a bunch of kids playing with Hot Wheels and shit.
Honestly, what if it like transitions into like a Ready Player One type of ordeal, where it's
so
just
mad.
Like a virtual reality?
So
these
mad.
Guys are plugged in the Matrix, and they're starting to realize it, and then they have to break out of the Matrix with cars.
Like, who else? Who else is there?
What you mean?
Like, what else is there to do?
Plenty.
Like,
give me toys.
Who else has a brother that we haven't seen for like 10, 20 years?
Letty. She can have a brother or sister. Now, see, you're being very short-sighted, and you're just like, what the hell's going on? Now, what I'm looking forward to the most...
If you say what I think you're going to say,
is
go
when...
Ahead.
I don't know what go you ahead, think I'm going to say. You can't read minds. Relax. Is when in Fast 10, when John Cena and The Rock are in the same movie.
I see.
That's what I can't wait
for. But I noticed that The Rock isn't in this one.
Because he was in Hobbs and Shaw. He's chilling.
Do you think he'll come back for the Fast series?
Oh, for sure. I think there's a Hobbs and Shaw 2.
I did hear that.
So, yes, he'll be back.
Then
I cannot wait for The Rock and Cena.
The
for
Rock
once in a lifetime.
Cena for the
fourth
time.
I can't wait. I'm excited for that. I was really disappointed he wasn't in this one.
Yeah, I was like...
But he was in the one last year, so whatever. But...
You know The Rock.
I
want to
see him go straight Jason Momoa on John Cena.
Why Jason Momoa? Oh, like do the...
Yeah,
do the
I want to go all that. I want all that.
That wasn't even
and
him.
And then John Cena to be like... Yeah, no, that was Roman Reigns.
Oh, then Roman Reigns.
Oh, dude.
Because now that's
and
tied
then,
in.
And then what happens is WWE's canon.
They have
a Royal Rumble.
All the wrestlers just go.
That's it.
Movies.
But no. Remember, I got John. My God, I figured out what's happening here. This is all a setup for a WWE Crush Hour movie.
Crush Hour.
You remember that? The WWE Twisted Metal game?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
This is all a setup for
they
that.
Turned it into Crush Hour. Oh, my God.
This is all a setup.
How many wrestlers have been in Fast and Furious?
Well,
technically Ronda Rousey now.
Ronda, The Rock,
John Cena,
Roman Reigns. That's all you need. A four-player split screen WWE Crush Hour.
Oh, yeah,
it's happening.
You
can
do it
four-way. And Jason Statham was in Death Race.
which is a Twisted Metal style movie where they're shooting. Look, so man. They do know. Look,
the,
man.
He was also not, what the hell? His like famous movies is like
the transporter.
Transporter.
He's a driver.
Also a driver in that.
And he was Another on. He was in movie. Crank.
He was in Crank.
That was
pretty sure there was cars in that movie.
Yeah, that was a crazy ass movie. You should watch that. You
should watch that.
He had sex at a horse track in front of everybody. That was cool.
And he also had sex in Chinatown.
That was cool.
It was just sex, really.
Yeah, that was a lot of sex. That was a good movie. But anyway, WWE Crush Hour movie coming
confirmed.
Soon. Calling it right now.
Confirmed.
It's happening.
You know what? I'm okay with the Fast series now.
You see?
If they decide it's like plot twist, we're doing Crush Hour. We're doing, what is it called? Crush Hour?
Crush Hour.
I wouldn't be too bad at it.
Hey, man. Dog, we just.
Alex.
What?
Is that the pitch of the week?
That's the pitch of the week. I
Holy
took it from you.
Shit.
Oh,
pitch of the week.
Hey,
awesome.
Alex's pitch of the week,
okay.
Number one.
There we go.
You might have one by the end of the day anyway. Yeah, so you knows? Might have a double feature pitch of the week.
But see, the peach of the pitch.
The peach of the week is in these pants, baby.
The pitch of the week is not designated per person, okay? It's per one. So it's like, it's not John's pitch of the week. It's our pitch of the week.
You didn't like that?
I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the audience. It's the podcast pitch of the week. So there's the one per week. There we go. We can move on.
Hey, man, we need a laugh track. That's what we need. A fucking laugh track. Not applause. Laugh track.
Why the fuck would we need a laugh track?
Friends had a laugh track.
It's also a sitcom and not an audio.
Hey, listen here, John. We're sitting down and communicating. Sitcom, boy.
Shut the fuck up, Alex.
See, if we had the laugh track right there, I'd be like, we're sitting down and communicating. Laugh track. The audience would go fucking wild because I'm just the funniest show ever.
You're
and then I won an Emmy.
Because I'm the funniest show. Like, Alex is a funny show.
See? Look at all the places I could put a laugh track. Matter of fact, it'd be nonstop laugh tracks because we're just hilarious.
I'm just going to stop talking to you, but I'm also going to tell you something. Did you know, like, did you see in the trailer John Cena tackled Vin Diesel,
his brother,
who looked nothing alike. Apparently, he's his younger brother, but he looks way older than him. I'm pretty sure he's not.
I don't know.
Both of those men are old, and he pushed him off a bridge that was on top of a truck, and they flew off the bridge.
Yeah, to land on concrete.
To land on, like, they're dead. I don't care what you tell me.
No, here's why. Captain America jumped out of the elevator thing and landed dead ass on his shield in the concrete.
Okay,
and he survived.
Okay, but look at this. Captain America, who's a super soldier.
Vin Diesel's
super
soldier.
No, but like, for all we know, he's not. But we know he is.
No, here's what.
But look at
the power of family, Jonathan.
This man, true, family can,
that's
family
what this,
over everything.
That's what this movie's about. And you know what? The next one will be called Family 10, Crush Hour.
Crush Hour. Fast 10, Crush Hour. Family 10.
Family 10.
It should be called Fast 10, Your Seatbelts. John's pitch.
Boo. 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 Nah. Boo.
It's called Crush Hour. Fast 10 your seatbelts.
Oh, my God. Hey, man. We made it a month into this podcast. We good. We didn't say what episode this was. I don't
episode
care.
Episode 5. Welcome to Play and Pod. Welcome to Play and Pod podcast.
Episode 5, too
five.
Many. Oh my God,
too many.
He said, "Fucking fast 10-year seatbelt."
I think that was a joke on the internet.
I didn't see that one.
Fast 10-year seatbelt.
That was the first time I heard it, and I'm not a fan of that.
No, that's a thing. That's a good one.
Oh man,
that's really good.
Let's.
If you do the, yeah, I swear to God, Alex.
What? Hold on. I was gonna say let's speed out of here. And talk about how the fucking Han came back real quick. Explain.
Oh, we're still on it.
This is the last thing I want to talk about this movie. Because I explain.
There's no need.
He died twice on screen in this franchise. One death. Like, let me clarify. One death. It happened in Tokyo Drift. And then they I'm still explaining to the audience when he died. He died in Tokyo Drift he died. Fuck it.
He did die.
And then in Fast 5 or 6... they redid it at the end to show that it was Jason Statham's character that killed him, and that he was coming for Dominic Toretto,
Cammy
for him. They made all that effort to show him die twice, to remind you that he died, to bring him back eating chips.
Like, he didn't die.
Like, he's just chilling. He was just chilling for five movies.
And then that dude, like, where were you?
Yeah, what the hell are you doing?
Like, you got brothers and fucking dead people coming back. Right. But that also happened with Letty, too, right?
Michelle, yeah, she died. But no, she, remember, I was telling you, Dom went back to the crash site years later and used his Witcher vision to see exactly what happened and where she went, because he's a Witcher.
You think anybody cares?
And Vin Diesel was in that season of the Witch movie, or whatever that movie was called, where he played a witch hunter, or whatever. John, I'm telling you right now, Witcher confirmed in WWE Crush Hour the movie.
He's the guest character?
He's the unlockable guest character. I'm telling you right now, it's happening. It's happening. That movie's going to be crazy. It's going to be the Smash Brothers of car movies and wrestling.
I'd be really mad. Did,
Speak into the mic, please.
Did WWE have guest characters?
Yeah, Terminator was in one. Right? Yeah, they have a couple. The Insane Clown Posse, Barack Obama, Spider-Man.
Okay, I'm not saying created characters. Oh. I'm saying like actual guest characters.
No, yeah, they had the Terminator. They had a couple.
I think that was it. No, the Terminator?
I think I don't remember. No, back in the day, they had a bunch of crazy wrestlers. I think you could pick Fred Durst in one of them.
Fred Durst.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken. Like they did it for a bit.
I'm picking Fred Durst. Fight Fred Durst.
I would also fight Fred Durst.
I just want to fight him.
But yeah, man, that's, I don't know. Pretty, I'm curious.
Wrestling, you think wrestling games should have more guest characters?
I think wrestling games should pause, take a look at the man in the mirror, and just
and make that change.
And make that change, because I was gonna say and stop because we had enough.
Oh,
they need to.
I thought you were gonna keep it.
No, I think they need to. That's still Michael Jackson.
I know.
They need to kind of, again, just take a break, relax. You don't need to come out every year like that, and revamp everything, because you guys are fucking up and obviously can't keep up with the. Obviously, there's a bunch of studio changes and stuff going on in the background, but you know the games are suffering, and wrestling games are some of the most fun games you can play with people in the same room. You know what I'm saying? Like back in the day, we would play the horrible ass WrestleMania 19 game or 17, 18, whatever on the GameCube. Hours, just hours and hours of fun. They don't have that anymore because now they're all super simulation and you know, like they had a good mix back in the day.
Yeah.
So I think they need to take a break. I'm not saying go back to the Here Comes the Pain or that, but maybe do something new because what you're doing now is not working. We're tired of it.
I was looking at the old Xbox captures, like, because, you know, you can record stuff on the, like, gameplays and stuff now.
Yeah.
And I saw that we were playing, I think it was 2K15 or 16. I forget.
Yeah.
But I just remember, like, how fun that was just because of how glitchy the game was.
Yeah.
And it's like, the fact that, like, we were, it was like you, me, it was like you against me against Rafa. And then, like, I was on the turnbuckle going to jump on Rafa, and you grabbed the stairs, and you, like, like you were trying to throw it into the ring.
Yeah.
But because because of the physics in it, because you tossed it into the ring, it hit me in the back of the head, and I just flew the fuck off the turnbuckle. I was laughing so hard.
Yeah, like, shit like that, man.
Wrestling games used to be the shit.
They used to, and like now we kind of have to go back and play the old ones to kind of relive that because the new ones ain't doing it.
And then like the old ones sometimes aren't all that great either. It's in my face. It's there.
I'm looking at your audio, and you're like way lower than me.
That's no, it's okay because you're loud.
Oh,
just a loud guy.
That could be it.
That's what it is.
That's probably it. Honestly,
that's all it is.
But John.
But no, what?
Speaking of loud, loud is a plant. Leaves are also plants.
Oh my goodness, bro. Are you serious right now? Is that really what the fuck you're about to do?
Leaves.
Don't disrespect me.
In
like
spring.
This, don't disrespect. Stop.
Come out new.
You're a fucking bastard.
Animal Crossing. I got I got another one.
What is that?
I got another one. Now, this one is obviously JK, because when I say it, you'll understand why.
Just say it.
What do you call when your mama crosses the street?
I don't like it. I don't like your joke. It's not a good joke. Because that's also your mama, so respect.
That's why I said JK.
Have some fucking respect for my mother.
Okay, yeah. Animal Crossing.
That's such a terrible fucking... That's so bad. It's not good.
All right, look, man. Animal Crossing's coming out. Are you excited?
Why didn't you just take my New Leaf one, man? Like, I don't understand.
What, isn't it called New Horizon or some shit?
I know, but New Leaf was an Animal Crossing game. That would have been a fine segue.
Okay, man, I got you. Speaking of Animal Crossing, New Leaf, over. There's a new Animal Crossing coming out. No, Animal Crossing, the Switch got announced. The Switch exclusive.
The Animal Crossing Switch.
And the internet went ablaze.
It looks so cool.
It looks awesome. I like it. The pastels joints, so the Joy-Cons.
The Joy-Cons.
They look awesome. The green and the blue.
Yeah.
They just look so cool. I like the whole thing, man. I like the whole thing. A couple of our people in our social circles are very strongly considering.
They're desperate.
I wouldn't say looking desperate,
Nah.
Okay, no, yeah.
They're depending desperate.
On, yeah, so one of them is desperately looking for it, but...
I'm not going to name names,
yeah, but...
I just want to see who gets triggered.
Anyway, for real, they're, it looks nice. It looks really nice. And then, yeah, that's pretty
much
that.
It looks nice. I don't play Animal Crossing like that, but I do want to get this one just because I think, like, the other ones did have co-op and stuff like that, but the fact that it's, like, 8 people can play it, I just imagine, like, 8 of us fucking around on someone's island. Like, I remember when it got announced, I was talking to Nathan, because he's really into Animal Crossing.
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, you could always do that, all this other shit. And he was like, you're not invited to my island because you're just going to be digging holes everywhere because apparently that's what they did.
No, dude, that reminds me. We were playing Viva Pinata and you can do a very similar.
Oh, my God. You were the fucking worst. You were the worst.
You mean the best?
Yeah, I remember that shit. I remember your little fucking shovel just floating around my goddamn. Just fucking digging. And you were doing it fast too. You were just like digging fast as shit. Yep.
Hey, I was trying to make sure you had enough holes for your crops or whatever the
even,
fuck.
Like, I didn't even have enough resources to fill those holes. I just like was following you around, just patching them back up.
I'm telling you, man, I was looking out for you.
Like, I imagine that.
Yeah, that
for Animal Crossing.
This is the first time I'm looking forward to the Animal Crossing game. When we were younger, I didn't give a shit about that. I just wanted to shoot things in the face and fight things in the face.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm looking forward to it just because, you know, games like Stardew Valley and things along that line, like, just kind of shift my perspective on farming games. And now that I don't have the amount of time that I used to sit down and play a crazy-ass, you know, Super Witcher 3 type of game, you know, like, I don't have that time anymore. So, right. You know, a sit-down casual game like Animal Crossing, I look forward to it.
Is that really considered, like, casual?
I mean, like a farm game. Like, it's not as... It's not as crazy a game as, say, Witcher. To learn, you know, because Witcher, you have to learn a ton of shit. In Skyrim, you have to learn a ton of shit. You know, this is a farm. Like, it's more simple. It's and I'm not saying it's you know, a piece of shit game or anything. But you get what I'm saying?
It's a different beast. It's a different beast.
What are you doing here?
Don't sit here and say you don't, like,
don't
compare. It's a different beast. The stuff you got to do in the game, you got to do some things in that game, and you got to learn the things. Don't sit here and act like you don't know. The things. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like you're going somewhere with that.
No, I was it.
Oh, man. I thought this was a nasty-ass transition coming out. That's why I'm like, I don't know. That's why I was like, what the fuck?
Nah, I'm just saying, man. Just don't.
No, I'm not.
Don't knock it till you try
it. I'm not knocking it. I'm just saying it's nowhere going to be as complicated as a Witcher game or something like that.
Because you said something about...
Or a Fallout.
You said something about Splatoon.
I didn't say anything about Splatoon.
Take it kindly.
I didn't say anything about Splatoon today.
Not today.
I said, I said nobody plays that bullshit anymore. They don't. Name me somebody that plays Splatoon. You can't. You name 4.
Stop doing that. Stop doing that.
Nobody plays that.
Nope. You can't say that. You gotta stop doing that.
No, I can, and I did. I'm gonna say it again. Nobody plays that. Anyway, I'm looking forward to Animal Crossing. Just cause.
I didn't realize that Doom also comes out same day as Animal Crossing.
Yeah.
So my wallet gonna be thin.
Yeah, I'm a little hurt that they did that to me. And then a couple weeks later, fucking Resident Evil 3 comes out. So
what?
Yeah, Resident Evil 3 comes out like 4/8
in March.
No, February. I mean, Jesus, April.
Excuse me.
April. Because the Animal Crossing and Doom comes out March 20th.
Uh-huh.
Resident Evil comes out April 4th or some shit like that. April 8th.
Okay.
Like the within the first 10 days of April.
Okay.
So I'm like, great. $60, $80, yeah. Another 60. And I'm not, and then you know what? By the time this one comes out, I'm not going to be done with Doom. I'm definitely not going to be done with Animal Crossing. I'm still fucking playing Witcher 3.
Yeah. Like, I'm still not done with Pokemon.
Yeah, I didn't beat that. Now we're playing this.
I just beat Luigi's Mansion. Couple.
That. Oh, I'm almost done with that. The fucking Toy World Toy Story shooter in the face game.
Hypercharge.
Hyper up.
Unboxing.
Unboxing some shit. That game's man. Fun.
Not sponsored. You should try Hypercharge Unboxing.
Is that really what it's called?
That's what it's called.
It's cool. It just came out on Switch on Friday.
Came out on the Switch.
It's fun. It's really
Friday.
Cool.
It's really, really cool.
It's a horde mode game thing, but it's fun.
Tower defense.
That.
Okay.
Yeah, technically.
Okay. You protect three
towers.
Generators.
Oh.
Different colors. Put traps down and stuff like that. The tower defense game.
Yeah.
And then you're a toy with a gun and you shoot other toys.
It's horde mode, man. It's a horde mode.
It's awesome.
I like it. I had a great time.
That's fucking great. Try that game out.
It's fun. Play with friends, you know. There's a multiplayer mode we haven't played yet.
Is it really?
Yeah. It's co-op and multiplayer. I'm pretty sure that one's just a run-of-the-mill shooter.
You think it's like...
What if it's tower defense versus tower defense?
That's what I'm saying. What if it's like Toy Soldiers where, you know, like Toy Soldiers is like...
Let's find out right after this real quick.
Real quick. I got to edit this bitch.
Oh.
We got a Super Bowl to go to.
Oh, yeah. The Super Bowl's today.
Also, Super Bowl's today.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
But, you know, we can't really say nothing because they're not going to.
No, I'm going to make a prediction.
Oh, wait. No, I got it. Okay. Because technically this comes out on
Monday.
Monday. So it's like, boy, howdy. That Super Bowl was crazy. Though my favorite commercial was the Doritos commercial.
Just going to.
Really good.
Just going to say very. All right.
That outcome was one for the history books. Not expecting that.
Bro, I could not believe when he caught the ball and scored
like that.
That shit was crazy.
You know what? And good on the person who did the halftime show. It was really good.
Oh, man.
Lots of football, lots of commercials. Very good stuff.
Very good. The food we had was
and
pretty good.
And I had
good.
Some good food on. And, boy, the sports.
Yeah, man.
It was real good.
Sports.
Well, we got to go. We have to do that later today. We got to go.
We do got to do that. But yeah.
There we go. And though that was that was what happened at the Super Bowl for us.
But, man, back to Animal Crossing. It came out that you can only have... One Iceland, which, fun fact, no, that's Greenland. Never mind. Disregard what I was saying.
What's wrong with you?
I was going to say, in Plague Inc., that's like the hardest place to get, but it's Greenland, not Iceland.
Yeah, Greenland. Fuck Greenland.
Yeah, when you play Plague Inc.
Iceland's also really hard to get, too.
Yeah, that game is fucking difficult.
Fuck those. Also, Plague Inc. for real is happening, but
yeah.
Continue.
Yeah, yeah, we'll talk about that in a second. What was I going to say? Yeah, one save file per console. Not per safe, not per profile, not per cartridge, but per console. Which I am in the middle in my opinion spectrum.
Yeah.
Because for personally, I have my own Switch. You have your own Switch. Our friends who are going to pick up the game have their own Switch. That doesn't impact us. But had this been a couple years ago and we were in it, we would have one Switch.
Yeah.
We would play on different profiles. That would be a pain in the ass if I'm working hard, you know, making my island real nice, and here comes John to fuck it up because he fucks it up. That'd be fucking annoying.
No. You would be fucking – if anybody's going to be fucking up islands here, it's you, okay?
Negative.
Because you just fuck shit up. You cannot do farming games.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. I'm telling you right now.
Yes, I can.
You can't.
No, you
can't.
Shut
up. No, your attention span does not allow you to play.
I'll have you know, my attention span has greatly improved,
Alex,
since I started reading.
Going from 0 to like maybe 2
isn't
that big of a jump.
That is a 200% improvement, bitch.
It's still low.
That's still 200%. And no, it's very high now. Go ahead.
I'm not.
Say something to me and I will pay attention to you
100%. That's not even close to what I was trying to say. It's not. Don't look at me like that. He just looks stupid.
This is my paying attention face.
No. No, you cannot. You get bored real fast and you start you start dicking around.
I'm not bored yet.
We're not playing the game, dickhead. But no, I was at first, my instinct was to be like, oh, this is kind of bullshit. Like, what about the people who have multiple save files for the Animal Crossing? Like,
yeah.
Just have multiple files, like families and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh, fuck those people.
This doesn't apply to me, like, so it's not a real problem.
Yeah, I'm blind to the issue. Because, I mean, I have a Switch. You have a Switch. Our people have a Switch.
No, the thing is, John.
And it's
if you want multiple save files, they've made a solution for you.
Buy a Switch.
Buy the Animal Crossing Switch that just came out. Oh, stupid ass, stupid head.
Or just buy the $200.
The Switch Lite.
Switch Lite, and then you're good to go.
But that's a problem.
I don't really. Yeah.
I just don't understand why.
Yeah, that was also kind of weird.
Like,
because I'm like, you telling me in this day and age, like, games before had save files. Why do you have to do that now? Like,
yeah, I don't know. It's really weird.
What's the purpose? Is it like you put way too much into it that it restricts it, or what's the problem?
Yeah, I don't know. Nintendo's always something.
Their practices are very strange. They do some good shit, and I was gonna say this with Animal Crossing because I've never played one, but I really want this one.
Yeah,
that I'm more appreciative of their games now.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And I'm more open to try their games now.
For sure.
I never wanted to play Legend of Zelda. I didn't give a shit. And then I beat like four.
Yeah, of them, not number four.
Four of them. Yeah. I didn't beat four Zeldas.
Yeah.
Breath of the Wild, Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, and.
Are you asking me?
No, I'm trying to. Rattle them out.
Oh, and then
Link Between DS Worlds.
One. Yeah, that one.
Yeah. I was supposed to be Wind Waker, but then Nathan asked for it back.
Wind Waker.
But yeah, like, beat Luigi's Mansion. I mean, I love Luigi. And then I like Pokemon, but I never took the time to beat it.
Yeah.
And I'm really close to beating this one. I've only beaten, like, two Pokemon now. Like, this has been my second.
Really?
Yeah, I've, like, never beaten a Pokemon except for Sun. No, Moon.
I didn't beat that one. I beat Yellow, Pearl. Shit. Hey, gold or silver, I think. One of them. Whichever one I own. Emerald? I don't remember. Whatever. One of those. Not emerald.
Now I'm more appreciative of the
diamond.
Games.
No.
Diamond?
I'm confused.
You don't even know what the hell.
The blue one. It had the crystal. It was crystal version. I had that one.
Yeah, but now I actually want to take the time and beat them. So, and like, I'm open to their new game. Like, not the new games, but their different IPs. Like, I would never care for an Animal Crossing, but now I want to try it.
Yeah.
Not going to try Fire Emblem. I don't care what you tell me.
No, Fire Emblem. No, hell no. I'm taking a stand against Fire Emblem.
You're fucking up my Smash, bro. Smash, bro. Speaking of, Byleth came out. The new Smash character.
I'm on a roller coaster. I'm on a roller coaster right now. All right, go ahead.
And that's how you segue, bitch.
It was so smooth. We're here.
Now we're here. But, Byleth came out on Monday. I forgot. Yeah, I played against Nathan, which was just a mistake in its own right. And fuck Byleth, dude. Is that even how you pronounce it?
It's
fuck you. I don't give a shit.
She's not good?
Dude, no, it's not that she's not good or it. The person's not good. He is so strong. Like, so strong. It's ridiculous. Like, her bow and arrow, it's basic bow and arrow.
All right, man.
Just 15%.
All right. I spent that whole episode calling them trannies. You can't keep calling it.
You keep calling it.
You can't keep calling it.
Because it's technically two characters.
Yeah, there you go. That's better.
I got Jax's head. Bullshit. They fucking. They shoot their bow and arrow, and it does 15% just on basic charge, because then it does a supercharge. They're fucking down B. They're special or whatever the fuck it is.
Yeah.
It charges up like a fucking falcon punch. It knocked me out. Like, I literally fell out. They are strong as shit. And with that down B.
Are they slow?
Yes and no. The recovery time in moves is kind of slow.
Mm.
But so they can get easily caught out. But, you know, I go into an anxiety-filled panic. when I go when I play against Nathan, so I didn't really get to capitalize on it. But yeah, man, like, beat my fucking ass. Like, the dog shit fell out of my ass. Like, how strong that down smash, the one that charges, ripped my shield off. Like, literally ripped off my shield. Like, you know when the shield breaks and the person's dizzy? That one move did it. And I was like, excuse me?
Excuse me.
It's nasty. Nathan was telling me that they buffed everybody else's shields and moves just to counteract. Like, they didn't nerf.
Why don't they just nerf her?
They fucking upgraded everybody else. And I'm like, just fix your broken character. Or stop letting in Fire Emblem characters. But I will say that it's not... They aren't just a... They're not just a Fire Emblem clone. Like, you can tell they put time into them, which makes me want to get them, but it's just... It's like... You know that character that... You know, like Ganondorf? He's, like, really, really strong.
Yeah.
For no fucking reason.
And well, he's like, Ganondorf.
Yeah, but, like, compared to everybody else, he's really strong. It's like that. So I don't really want him. But, man... Fuck Nathan. Fuck Byleth.
He didn't even do nothing.
Beat my ass.
Oh, okay, that's a good reason.
Dog shit out of me, and I don't like it. So I'm going to take my platform to say, fuck you.
Hey, we're going to have him on the pod.
We should have
him on the pod one of these days. He's going to talk shit.
Fuck you, too. And we're not playing Smash either, because he's going to talk shit.
No.
So we're not doing that. We play a game we like Mortal Kombat.
We already played Mortal Kombat.
Play it again. But what about when Spawn comes out?
Oh, okay.
We got to play Mortal Kombat when Spawn comes
out? Yeah, yeah.
How else would be people going to know? You keep talking shit. You keep talking shit, but you fucking...
Hey, man.
You lost to me three times in a row.
Where's the proof? There is none. Okay, look. I have just one final note here.
Okay.
Before we go. You know, we're playing new games now. We should play classic games out here.
Like what?
Mortal Kombat Gold.
Oh, you're serious about that. Why do you want to play Mortal Kombat Gold on here?
I like Mortal Kombat Gold.
Gold is ugly.
What? John, you're ugly, and I don't care.
Sir,
I have to sit here and...
Sir. You're not going to do me like that.
I'm saying, because, yeah, new games are cool and all, but there's some heat out there.
There is some heat.
Remember, we used to have a series called Does It Hold Up here, where we played classic games to see if they hold up in their original format?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it's not... We didn't used to... We're in pre-production.
Why are you formally making that announcement that I walked you to, John?
Because we said it in a video already.
Uh-oh.
Do you not remember?
I have a really bad memory.
I ate mustard.
Oh, shit. I still taste that mustard. Not the one you ate. Mine.
Yeah, we ate mustard.
Yeah, that was horrible.
And then we talked about that.
That was horrible.
What are you talking about?
Hey, man.
Go ahead.
Let's just take a moment before we sign off here to discuss our dying YouTube channel.
Yeah.
A moment of silence.
As we go on, we remember all the times we...
Because, man, every upload, John, every upload,
yes,
we drop a couple subs.
Every
We were almost at 2,000 subscribers, and now we're at...
We're about to hit 1,800.
We're about to hit 1,800s.
You could save a dying channel.
That's not what I was going. I was just bringing that up just because
No. Here we go. I got you. You could save a dying channel with just one click of the subscribe button.
No.
Perhaps pressing that share button to your friends and family who may also like playing and podding.
Look, I was going to say I get it because we're only doing a podcast and everybody has a podcast and blah, 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 blah. We're going to come up with some heat. Come out with
some
meat.
I'm going to eat more mustard.
Yeah.
Whatever it takes.
We're going to eat mustards, and then we're going to say we're going to live stream, and we're not going to do it. That's how we do it here.
For real, we did say we were going to try to do that every month.
That's how we're going to do it. All right?
All right.
So stick with it.
Stick with it, because we're dying. Yeah.
No, I took that.
Nothing breeds encouragement like we're dying.
We're dying.
Stick with us.
We got it. No. I bring that up just to say that I really do appreciate the people that stay. Because
there's
names and people that I know that have been there from the beginning, regardless.
Yeah.
So, like, again, I still firmly believe that the people leaving are those either fake accounts, closed accounts, or stuff from the stream era that we had where, you know, they were just buffing up our numbers so we can stay up. Streaming, I mean. Because we used to do those during stream. That's all it is. Those numbers don't concern me. Because another reason I brought it up is because some fans
would mention that's like, damn, you guys are, you know, going down to subs and you used to have, you know, 2000 and blah, blah, blah. That's the only reason why I bring it up. I'm not, I didn't bring it up to be like, oh, poor us and that. No, never that.
Poor us. Save me.
No, that's not what
why
I meant.
Why am I doing this?
Please.
I'm sick. And for what?
No, that's all I brought it up for. Just because people bring it up and I wanted to address it on the podcast. That's all. That is all.
Nah.
That is all. Wink, wink, you know share, what? Wink, wink.
You too can save a dying channel.
All right, man. All right. Hey, thank you so much for listening. Today's episode was a little shorter than normal, I think. About around 50. A little shorter. But we have a commitment
to go to here. Very important.
We cannot get out of it. It's very, very important. It's definitely not the Super Bowl.
Right.
Definitely not the Super Bowl.
It has nothing to do with any bowls.
No, never. No soup or bowls. Nope. So, anyway, we'll see you guys next Monday again for another episode of The Playing Pod with Alex and John, the only video game podcast that plays while we pod. Hey.
Holy shit.
And make sure to hit that like. Make sure to subscribe. Make sure to follow us on Spotify, Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. And, Europe.
Yes, all of that. Make sure to communicate with us. Let us know about the stuff we talked about, what you think.
Yeah.
Because we reply.
We do reply.
That's right.
All right.
Dude, hit the clap.
I'm going on. I got to
beat it.
I do really got to go, though, because I have an appointment.
Yeah, beat it out.
I have an emergency appointment with my doctor. Paging Dr. B. Emergency. I'm
sick. I got the coronavirus. Only the music can save me now. Have a good week, fellas.
You're broken.
I hope it heard that.